Hey, Cop XC8 back again with another video. I'm on the road, might as well do a couple. So this is the third overview of my vacuums. You saw the shawbag, how I'm in my shawbag with Kenmore Powerhead. And you also saw the Kenmore Evo overview. This is the same thing with the bissels clean view 2 bagless plus. First of all, it's an upright. This is the only upright vacuum I've owned. I'm more of a canister vacuum type of guy, but this one changed my mind. It works really well. It is a clean view 2 bagless plus. Here it is up close. There you go, gave you some time to read it. Got the rough filter. On off switch. Here is the brush. There we go. The big white pad head. They call this the powerfull in the owner's manual. There we go. See? Turns very well. This is the height adjustment. So the big wheels on the back. You saw this one in my previous video. Kenmore Evo versus Bissell Clean View 2. Here is the dust cup. It's actually a two-part dust cup, which is pretty rare. You have the dust that spins around and goes into this tube and goes into here. This is the second filter. It has one here. This is the second filter. Under this there is another filter. Hope I don't do that last time and get some dust everywhere. Here is the other filter. There we go, that's been put back together. Here is the foam line. This is the first filter I was talking about. It's more of a plastic screen than anything else. I thought that filters actually filters the dust. The dust comes on top of it. The dust comes in here, spins around, goes through this filter. There we go. This is the screen, the lightning. Twist that. And spins around. Goes into the tube, the other filter comes out and goes into the pre-motor filter and then comes out in the HEPA filter. This is a bissell. Maybe it's not seen that enough, apparently not, it doesn't show. Anyhow, this is a bissell style 7. Black side in, white side out. So this machine has a lot of filters. If you've been following, this is 1, 2, 3. Don't forget there's a mousse filter and a paper cartridge underneath. And then the dash 3, the pre-motor filter, 4, and the HEPA, 5. Yeah, 5. I was surprised when I bought it. I've had it for about a year, maybe 2 years. Didn't have to replace the filter yet, so no complaints there. Works really well. Here is the lever. Here it comes out. Pull it back, good slot.
hold it, but
oh yeah. Okay. Yes,
there we go. Here is that's not ready. The height adjustment, it has seven height adjustment.
You also notice that it had the highlight on it too. Here is the stretch hose, meters a handle, strong plastic handle. It turns 360 degrees. Got the wand built into the handle. The hose, you can see it stretch very long. The wrench not long, stretch about this long. Stretch pretty long. I'd say 7 to 8 feet in short stretch. And here is the brush I use into the test camo versus bissel. It's actually two tools in one. This side is for the upholstery. This side is for all the dusting. All you do is turn it. See? Now it's for dusting. The opening is there. And now it's for upholstery. It comes out. Small block, but it does a really good job with this machine. Here is the wire. This side goes into the tube with the machine. As you can see, it's pretty much like a filter cleaner or a hoover. The big side of the machine, small side of the wire. Take a look. Has also a cord holder. Keep it down, the cord comes off. Flip it back up. Go on, go on, go on. Okay, got it on. Right here, you'll notice it is missing the turbo brush. It broke, as usual, did not last long. Might don't anyway. Don't go on. It has a handle release at the bottom. The silent height adjustment selector. And so here's the head up close. Here's the head, almost in bare floor. Low carpet. A little bit higher. Medium. Higher, very high. Now it is at the high carpet position. You have sudden height adjustment, which is very nice. Again, features a bright headlight. Here's the lever for locking the dust cap. It's really big dust cap actually. As you can see. From there to there, it's pretty big. Here's the lever, the headlight shows that lever. Here's the upper, the switch. Now, can't go any lower. But if you press on it again, it lays completely flat. So you can see that it's totally flat. Normal cleaning, there, so, right now, flat to do under the bed or any furniture, so it is much easier to clean, there's a big wheel, one on each side, dual edge cleaner, right here, edge cleaners, here also.
not going to remove it, but there's a cover here. We'll lift this tab here, 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 and here. This whole part comes off and can service the belt. I'm sure it doesn't take much control, yeah. Here's one. Just let them off. Not connected, but you lift up the tab and can service the belt. That's pretty much the overview of my bissel. Okay. Here is the storage compartment for the tools. One goes here. Here's the part that connects to the power head. And then testing and everything. So, yeah. Comes back in, stays in. And up here. You bring the hose here. Take it out. Come back on. Sure, it's machine. And this vacuum works really well. Use the HEPA filter again. If my memory serves me well, this is 15 inch wide. The head here is 15 inch wide, which is great. Covers a lot more area at one time. It is a 12 amp motor, just like the Kenmore, and the shovel, I think it's a 7 amp motor. I'm not too sure. I'll have to check. I'll get back to you. Flip it down, cone comes off. Yeah, so that's pretty much it for the bissel. The back you'll get will make me the sticker for the model number. It takes the style 7 belt and filters. So that was the overview of my vacuum, the bissel, the Kenmore, and the shawback. So don't forget to subscribe and comment on Compact C8. Take care. Come back for more.